Welcome to Sitam Church Online. This is Pastor Karita Mbagara, the Deputy Bishop of Christ is the Answer Ministries, also known as Sitam. For this series that we are starting today, which is a three-part series, I want us to look at Paul's way of doing ministry. We will be looking at his own testimony as recorded in the book of Acts chapter 20, starting from verse 17, where he invites some elders for a retreat. These were elders from a church in Ephesus, and he brought them to a place called Miletus. And it is while he is there that he speaks about the way he has worked. And we will see some principles of the way the ministry of Paul was carried out. In verse 20 of that chapter, he says that he taught the people what was profitable for them. Just listen to what the scriptures say. "You know that I have not hesitated to preach anything that would be helpful to you, but have taught you publicly and from house to house." In other words, Paul was given to teaching what was going to help the people. He was adding value in the lives of the people that he was ministering to. And God invites us to be value adders, if there is such a term, in the lives of the people that we minister to or the people that we encounter. Every one of us is a minister. May not be a church, it could just be in a small study group, but wherever it is, we should be adding value. But Paul goes further in verse 21. If you read it, he taught that people must repent. So the need for repentance was key in his preaching, because he realized that there is no way we were going to be acceptable before God if we are not teaching repentance. It is repentance that brings us into fellowship with God. You can be remorseful, but remorse is not enough. Repentance means that you are remorseful, but you are also inviting God or recognizing God's help, that He is willing to help you and to bring you back into fellowship with Him. Thirdly, we find that he says that he taught about the grace of God and His kingdom. And that is found in verse 24 and 25, that he brought the whole aspect of God's kingdom to bear in the lives of his listeners. Fourthly, we find that he says that he taught the whole counsel in verse 27 of God. In other words, the teaching of Paul was thorough. But not only his teaching was thorough, he says that his methods were also thorough. Why do I say his methods were thorough? Because he taught publicly, but he also taught privately. He was doing it whenever he got an opportunity. No wonder that he was later to write to Timothy and say, whenever there is opportunity, share the word of God. Whether it is in season or out of season, whether it's convenient or not. So Paul took every opportunity that he had to share about the Lord Jesus. So we have seen his teaching was thorough, but we also have found that he had his methods that were also thorough. But thirdly, he was also thorough in his coverage, because he tells us that he was teaching this word both to Jews and to Greeks. In this passage, when you read it, you will find that he says that even the Jews were opposed to him, but he was still teaching them the word of God. It is like Jesus, who had a disciple by the name of Thaddeus. We are not very sure about what he did. He didn't seem to be very significant in the ministry of Jesus, but he taught it. Jesus also was having a disciple by the name Judas Iscariot, a person who was, later to betray him, but he still was teaching him. And what that is telling us is that we should share the word of God with all people, because we do not know who God has appointed unto salvation. Let us follow this example by Paul, being thorough in our teaching, being thorough in our methods, and being thorough in our coverage. Let us not leave anybody out. God has invited us to be ministers to all that need to hear the word of God. And may God help you as you practice this. I would want to hear what you think about what I have said using the social platforms that are listed here below. God bless you.